Hey guys, so today we'll talk about the Lagrangian cost minimization problem. And in this picture, Lagrange looks pretty sad, but this is because this picture was taken before he knew how to minimize costs. And I promise that by the end of this video, both you and Lagrange are gonna be very happy. So let's review. We have our production function. And as always, it has two inputs, capital and labor. A is productivity, K is capital, alpha is the capital share of production, and L is labor, just like before. But now we add another function, the cost function. It also has two variables, capital and labor, and two new parameters, R and W. They stand for rent and wage. And rent is the cost of your capital, so how much you have to pay for the fields or the machinery, how much you have to rent it for. And W is the wage, or how much you pay your workers. Pretty self-explanatory. Now let's get to the actual problem. It reads something like this. A firm wants to minimize total costs while having a fixed output. What does that mean in simple terms? That means that a company wants to make a certain number of widgets, a popular word used in economics, but they want to spend as little money as possible. So let's set up our example. Let's say that output, or Y, is equal to 4,000 widgets. Productivity is 10. The capital share of production is 1/3. Rent is $100. And wage is $25. So knowing this, let's set up the Lagrangian. All right, like before, we have our production function up here and the cost function, but now we plug in the numbers that we know. So for the production function, we'll have 4,000 equals 10 times capital to the 1/3, labor to the 2/3, and the cost function will be 100K plus 25L right here. And now we can set up the Lagrangian, and it looks like this. With a production function under the Lagrange multiplier. And now we need 5 steps to solve this problem. So the first step will be to find the partial derivatives with respect to K and L. The second step is to solve for lambda. The third step is to find the relationship between capital and labor. So we'll write it out as L equals a function of K. The fourth step would be to plug in our K and L into the production function to find the actual values. And the final step will be to plug in K and L into the cost function to find out how much money the company will need. So let's get to step number one. It's pretty simple here, just the partial derivative. So we have the Lagrangian again, as you see here, and we take two partial derivatives, the first one with respect to capital and the second with respect to labor. And we set them both equal to zero. So let's get to step number two. Here we have to solve for lambda. So we know that we already have the partial derivative, so all we have to do is carry over the lambda in both sides and we'll have these two neat little equations. Pretty simple as well. So let's get to step number three. Now, since we know that this lambda is equal to this and the second lambda is equal to this, and of course lambda is equal to lambda, so surely that must mean that this is equal to this, and that's exactly what we have. Now, what I like to do is write out all the fractions of K and L and their powers, even if they're negative, so it's easier to multiply. So in the first step, we get rid of the improper fraction, and we just have 8 over here. And now you notice that if we multiply the second equation by L to the 2/3 times K to the 1/3, which we can write out, then everything simplifies really neatly, and some things even cancel out. And we're left with the main equation of 8K equals L, which is the relationship we were looking for. Now for the fourth step, we have to plug it into our production function to figure out the exact values. So like before, we have 4,000 equals 10 times k to the 3rd, L to the 2/3, but now for L, we substitute 8k, which we do right here. And when we write it out, we get that k equals 100, and from what we know from before, that L equals 8 times k, so L is equal to 8 times 100, or 800. And finally, we plug those numbers back into our cost function to find out how much money we will spend. And what we get is 100 times 100 plus 25 times 800. So the total money that the company will have to spend under these conditions of the rent and wage, and if they want to make 4,000 widgets, they'll need to spend $30,000. See, I told you you'd be happy. Thanks for watching our economics videos. We love helping you learn. Please be sure to subscribe and check out our other topics.